sea, somewhere waiting for me.
Wow, this actually happened. Like, about a year ago, I created a stupid awards show where I nominated a bunch of movies for all these awards, and I gave them the awards. I had no idea what I was doing. It was all me. It was pretty lonely, and I didn't even watch the premiere when it came out, because I slept through the premiere. So essentially speaking, the 2019 MTS Movie Awards were a disaster. But I'm happy I made them, because they inspired me to make, today, the 2020 MTS Movie Awards. I had no clue. I had this idea of, hey, what if I invited a bunch of other YouTube channels to make this actually happen? And I never thought I'd actually go through with it, but I ended up going through with it. I've spent the last 3 months working constantly on this. If you're wondering why there haven't been nearly as many videos on my channel, part of the reason is because this has been a huge project. It has taken a lot from not just me, a lot of other people. There are so many people that have helped me with this project. There are a lot of people who even went out of my way. When somebody wasn't able to do a feature, I was able to get one of the people to do a second entry for the, they were able to pull out two awards now. Like, they're announcing too. So I just want to thank everybody who even decided to come on this project. It's absolutely awesome for somebody who has 288 subscribers to get somebody with 140,000 to make a video with me. No matter how much, it only took you a minute to record a video, and even if you didn't really put much effort into it, I'm still amazed that this actually happened. So I'm excited to feature all the YouTubers I'm about to read off. We're going to read all them off, and then I'm going to give a little introduction, and then we'll get into the awards. So the people, and by the way, if you have X's on my hands, I went to a concert. So, people who helped me with this award show, I'll first say the Tatermeister is basically the co-runner of this. He stepped in to do a lot. Like, he helped me get connected with a lot of other YouTube channels, told other people, hey, you want to join when I was lacking people. He helped a lot. He even is doing two awards tonight. So I'm so thankful for him. He helped me a lot while making this. So just go subscribe to him. He has a lot more than me, but still, go support him. And I'm even doing a podcast with him now. So yeah, another person on the podcast also helped. Christian Paystrup was a good help here too. He's in this award show. He's also in the podcast called The Film Sharks now. Go listen to it. It's a lot of fun. It's on Tate's channel, which is in the description. So thanks to Christian. Thank you to Cineflect as well. He was a lot of help, and he does award show. Thanks to Zach Pope, who is a relatively large YouTube channel. So I'm very happy that he was able to make it here. Biggest one here, most popular one, obviously, is Sean Chandler. I'm amazed that he even's on this, and he'll be announcing the first award tonight. DJ Wolf, my brother, I've known him for 14 years, because that's how long I've been alive. He'll be doing an award at the very end. So, well, thanks to him for doing this, and he's putting quite a lot of effort into his video, so I'm very excited for you guys to see it. Thank you so much, DJ Wolf. Thanks for being a great YouTube friend, even though you're my brother, and I have 200 more subscribers than you. Thanks to Joshua Drake as well for doing an award. Jaren Talks Movies, Ryan O'Toole, and Lance MC Sneed. By the way, I didn't list those off in the awards they're going. A lot of those are just the way I list them off, okay? They're the people who confirmed first, stuff like that. So anyway, so how we're going to start this off is first, Best Actor will be presented by Sean Chandler. Then we'll go to Best Actress being presented by Joshua Drake. Then we're going to go to Best Actor being presented by Tatermeister. I'll cut in the middle of those to introduce them. And then we will go to our first commercial for my own films, because I'm putting my own promotion, because this is a huge YouTube video. That'll be playing after these three. The ad, you'll see when it comes up, actually. So yeah, it's about 30 seconds long, the ad. So, without further ado, here is the one and only Sean Chandler presenting Best Actor.
Hey, Sean Chandler here from Sean Chandler Talks About, and I'm going to announce the winner for Best Actor. And the nominees are Adam Driver from Marriage Story, Joaquin Phoenix from The Joker, Robert De Niro from The Irishman, Taron Egerton from Rocketman, and Adam Sandler from Uncut Gems. So when I look at this list, you got five great nominees. Any of them winning, I'd be fine with it, because they're all great performances. The least interesting one to me is Robert De Niro, because it's not that it wasn't a good performance, but it's stuff we've seen him do before in a type of film that we've seen Scorsese do before, so it's not fully interesting to me. But, you know, I get excited when I see Adam Sandler making a comeback and having people think that he might be the best actor for the year, and a bunch of fun things in there. Of course, I'm a comic book movie guy, so seeing Joaquin Phoenix for The Joker, that's very exciting. Rocketman, I love to see kind of the up-and-comers. And Adam Driver was fantastic in Marriage Story. So, any of them are possibilities, but who is the winner? Joaquin Phoenix for The Joker. It's a great performance. I mean, he just disappeared into Arthur and then from Arthur into the Joker, and he pulled all of it off with perfection. You believed it was real. You rooted for him while not wanting him to actually turn into the Joker. So, hey, absolutely a fantastic performance and worthy of winning Best Actor.
And now, go subscribe to Sean Chandler, link in the description. If you haven't already, have no idea how you wouldn't have subscribed to Sean Chandler, because he has 140,000. And I'm very happy he featured on this. Next, we have Best Actress being presented by Joshua Drake. Joshua, take it away.
Hello everyone, it is me, Joshua, aka Future Filmmaker 3.0, from Future Filmmaker 3.0 Movie Reviews, where I talk film, TV, music, over my channel here over at MTS The Shark Movie Reviews. He invited me on to present the nominations of his little award show for Best Actress. So the poll results are in, and I do have the list of nominees right here. So here we are. So let's go into who is the winner of Best Actress. First, let's start off with the nominees. Scarlett Johansson, Marriage Story. Ana de Armas, Knives Out. Florence Pugh, Fighting with My Family. Clara Ruggert, I Am Mother. And Awkwafina for The Farewell. Those are the nominations. And the winner for the MTS The Shark Award for Best Actress is Scarlett freaking Johansson for Marriage Story. Woo-hoo! Now, all the nominations are spot on. I do love the nominations that he decided to put in. And Scarlett Johansson gave a great performance in Avengers Endgame and Jojo Rabbit, but Marriage Story is where I think she really shines. And I do hope it's between Jojo Rabbit and Marriage Story that she gets an Academy Award for her performance, because Scarlett Johansson, she is a great actress, and she really brought her A-game here in Marriage Story, which was a good film. Your nominees get really great performances too, but I'm not really going to complain about it too much, to be exact. Now, I do wish that Ana de Armas won for Knives Out, because she was really, really great in that movie, but I'm not going to complain too much. So, on my opinion, I'm probably fine with these nominations and with the winner. So I want to thank you, Mark, for having me on your channel. Be sure to come over to my channel and subscribe for film reviews, TV reviews, music reviews, top 10 lists, rankings, etc., etc. I'll see you guys in all that. You guys keep it cool and join the epitasticness. Bye-bye.
Thanks, Joshua Drake. That was a good video. I mean, all these are great, but that was good. Then next, we are being presented by the person who decided to do two tonight, the Titermeister. I think I said the name wrong. He's presenting Best Supporting Actor, good friend of mine here on YouTube. So here you go, Tate, take it away.
Yo, it's your boy, the Titermeister, back again on the MTS Movie Awards. I guess I'm not done yet. Yeah. So, someone was supposed to do this category, but I'm going to do it because, well, we got to get the show over with, right? But I'm glad to be back on the show. Yes, I'm going to be doing Best Supporting Actor as well as Best Director. I didn't expect to be doing this twice, but hey, I'm happy about it. I got to be shown twice. And make sure you go subscribe to me after this video, please. The Tatumizer, just type it into YouTube, or I guess click the link in the description if Mark puts it in the description. But anyway, so, here are the nominees for Best Supporting Actor. Alright, so here are the nominees for Best Supporting Actor for the MTS Movie Awards 2020. We have Joe Pesci from The Irishman. I personally didn't think he was that impressive in that, but whatever. Chu Woo-shik Parasite, very impressive performance. Parasite acting was amazing. Taika Waititi, Jojo Rabbit? I mean, I guess he was good in that, but I don't think he's the standout. Tom Hanks, A Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood. A lot of people remember that movie for him. And Zach Gosigan, The Peanut Butter Falcon. I think he was amazing in that. Probably the best, one of the best supporting actors, best supporting performances in this last year of 2019. So, without further ado, guys, it is time to reveal who won Best Supporting Actor at the 2020 MTS Movie Awards. And the winner is... Let me see. The winner is... It is Tom Hanks! Yes. For A Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood. Tom Hanks, you've done it, me boy. I honestly, was it gonna be anybody else? Let's be real here. I mean, he's like the main reason that movie's amazing. I mean, not saying the other actors and people in the movie weren't good, but I think the main people thing remember from A Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood is Tom Hanks. Tom Hanks, you are the legend. I'm sorry you didn't get nominated for this, for the Oscars. Did he get nominated for the Oscars? Well, Brad Pitt was gonna beat him no matter what, but don't matter. So I'm happy you won here, Tom. You definitely deserved it. And I don't get why Brad Pitt wasn't nominated for this show, I guess. I think because Mark didn't watch Once Upon a Time in Hollywood before he did the show. But anyway, thank you all for watching. And continue to watch the show and make sure you subscribe to me. Tate Meister is signing out once again. Bye.
Thanks, Tate, for doing two awards for me. And I actually quite agree with the win of, with Tom Hanks. He deserves that. Now let's get into the first ad, which is for my films. They're not for other films. These films are made by me in my studio. So here they are. That is right, the new film from KFDM Studios, my studio, Night Owl Phase 2, comes out March 27th. See it when it comes out that day. It'll be released on YouTube on the KFDM Studios YouTube channel, so go subscribe to my channel and my studio. And I created Night Owl all by myself, both movies. So now we're going to be going through three more awards. These awards are... Crap. These are Best Supporting Actress, being presented by Ryan O'Toole. If I'm saying that name right. Best Director, another one being presented by the Tate Meister. This is his second award he's presenting tonight. And Best Cinematography being presented by the one and the only Cineflect. Here you go.
Hey, what's going on, guys? I'm Ryan O'Toole. I'm a movie reviewer here on YouTube, and I was invited to present the award for Best Supporting Actress. And the nominations are Zhao Zhuzhen for The Farewell, Dakota Johnson for The Peanut Butter Falcon, Jamie Lee Curtis for Knives Out, Hilary Swank for I Am Mother, and Park So-Dam for Parasite. And the winner for Best Supporting Actress is Zhao Zhuzhen for The Farewell. Zhao Zhuzhen totally deserves this award out of the nominated actresses in this category because she was completely overlooked by the Oscars this year. I have no idea why the Academy didn't nominate anything for The Farewell, not just Zhao Zhuzhen, but Awkwafina for Best Actress. Everybody loves Nai Nai the Grandmother, and I'm totally happy that she won in this category.
Thanks, Ryan, for presenting that award for me. Now let's go to Best Director, being presented by Tate, which I think this award actually should be later in the night, but who cares, really? The only thing that matters is that Worst Picture and Best Picture at the very end. Take it away, Tate. This is a big award here, actually.
Hello, everybody. It is your boy, the Tate Meister here, with the MTS Movie Awards. Yes, it is here, finally. And I'm a part of it. Wow. So, I have an honorary job of announcing the winner for Best Director for the MTS Movie Awards. And it was a close one. We had, hold on, what were the choices again? Alright, so here are the nominees for Best Director of the 2020 MTS Movie Awards. We had Noah Baumbach for Marriage Story, Martin Scorsese for The Irishman, which I don't think that movie's that great, but Todd Phillips for Joker, Taika Waititi for Jojo Rabbit, and Bong Joon-ho for Parasite. All great choices. Unfortunately, Sam Mendes did not make it for 1917, which I guess is annoying, but that's fine. I guess MTS didn't watch 1917 before this. So, anyway. So this was a really close poll. This was a really close vote to who should win Best Director. But without further ado, the winner of Best Director for the 2020 MTS Movie Awards is Taika Waititi. Congratulations, Taika. It was well deserved. This was a very close poll, that one that I had to vote for and decide on. I really could just not think of anybody better than Taika Waititi for this. After watching Jojo Rabbit, I could safely say that was the best directed film of last year. It was, you know. I'm glad everybody voted for this. This was a very tough, very close vote. But Taika Waititi, congratulations. This was well deserved. Jojo Rabbit is in your masterpiece. Not to say I don't love Joker. Joker's a 10 out of 10 for me. Todd Phillips is, you know, Taika Waititi is technically a better director. He made a lot more movies, and he's just a wonderful director. Jojo Rabbit was pretty much amazing as frick, so if you watch the movie, you'll know why this was one award. So thank y'all for watching, and continue to watch the MTS Movie Awards. More awards to follow soon enough. Bye-bye, Tate Meister, signing out.
Thanks, Tate, although I'm not happy you dissed The Irishman, although we'll never agree on that movie. I think it's amazing you don't. Now, let's go to one of my favorite YouTube channels, Cineflect, who did an incredible job presenting cinematography. This is a great video. Just trust me, you'll love it. Here you go, Cineflect, take it away.
Oh, hello. Here are the nominees for Best Cinematography. Parasite, Hong Kyung-pyo. Uncut Gems, Darius Kanji.
Arctic, Thomas Orn Thomason.
Ad Astra, Hoyt van Hoytema.
Ford v Ferrari, Fiedan Papamichael.
Okay, and the MTS Award for Best Cinematography goes to... Whoa, we actually have a tie between Ford v Ferrari and Ad Astra, and I have instructions here from the shark himself saying that I get to be the tiebreaker. Well, in that case, I would have to go with Ad Astra, Hoyt van Hoytema. You know, James Gray set out to make what he was calling the most realistic space film ever made, and to do that, he enlisted Hoytema, who previously worked with Christopher Nolan in Interstellar. And, well, the results speak for themselves. I think it's interesting that among these nominees, you have a lot of examples of isolation and claustrophobia, and I thought there was some really incredible work this year in what was altogether a fantastic year at the movies. So, again, congratulations to all the nominees, and especially to Ad Astra and Hoyt van Hoytema.
And now, here's the second ad of the night for another KFDM Studios movie. Let's go to it. Is that it?
Yep, that's it.
That's right, Seven Strings releases April 24th, a new film being presented by the same people who created Project 87. Me and Christopher are back making another horror movie, this time it's about ghosts. April 24th, once again on the KFDM Studios YouTube channel. Now, let me scroll down a bit. We got three more awards, as usual, on these. Actually, no, we got two more. I'll be doing two more than an ad, because we're getting to the end, guys. Best Visual Effects is going to be presented by Zach Pope. Then, Best Musical Score being presented by Lance M. Sneed. That's right, yes, I got the name right. Okay, anyway, take it away, Zach. You're on my favorite YouTube channel, so I'm very happy to have you here.
Hey guys, welcome to the MTS Awards show. Today I'm going to be presenting the visual effects for best visual effects of 2019. And the nominees were Avengers Endgame, Ad Astra, Godzilla King of Monsters, Star Wars Rise of Skywalker, and Spider-Man Far From Home. Now these are all great mentions. I'm surprised Alita Battle Angel didn't get in there. I would have personally put that in there. But I don't know what I would have taken out because Endgame was amazing. Ad Astra was just superb the way that they were able to bring together the space and all that sorts of goodies. Godzilla, what's there to say? They made me believe that Godzilla was real. Star Wars Rise of Skywalker was just excellent to look at. And Spider-Man Far From Home probably has some of the best visual effects scenes in the whole entirety of the MCU. But your winner is, drumroll, it's Avengers Endgame! Yay! Thank you so much, MTC, to having me on the show. Glad I could be in it. And thank you so much for having me. If you guys want to check out more movie content, head over to my channel, Zach Pope Reviews, and hit that like and subscribe button.
Once again, thanks to Zach for actually featuring on this, because that's a huge feature for me. Then, Best Musical Score being presented by Lance M. Sneed. He might actually have the best video of the night. No offense to anybody else, but this is a pretty great video. Just get to it.
Hello, I'm High Heel Knight. Thank you very much, MTS The Shark, for giving me the opportunity to present the award for this category. Music has been an essential part of the filmmaking experience almost since the medium began. Even before there was actual sound on film, theaters would have instrumentalists playing music during the films in order for the audience to get a better understanding of what was going on the screen. And where would great movies like Jaws or Godfather or Star Wars be without their awesome musical scores? So I'm really happy I get to present this award. Granted, I'm probably going to butcher the names of some of these nominees, so please forgive me. The nominees for the MTS Movie Award for Best Musical Score are Randy Newman, Marriage Story; Alan Silvestri, Avengers Endgame; Hildur Guðnadóttir, Joker; June Jalil, Parasite; Daniel Lopatin, Uncut Gems. And the movie award goes to Hildur Guðnadóttir. I obviously can't pronounce your name properly, but definitely you get what you deserve. And that's the award for Best Musical Score. So congratulations to her. And thanks again, MTS The Shark, for giving me the opportunity. Remember, find inspiration everywhere.
Thank you so much, Lance. Thank you so much for the great video. You gave me three options. I picked the best one, in my opinion, which is the longest one. I thought it was great. You did a great job encapsulating the whole award. You did great editing. And I'm also very happy that Joker's score won for that. Now, we have another ad, which is the ad for the next KFTM Studios movie, Let's Go To It. That's not called Let's Go To It. I'm just saying Let's Go To The Ad, whatever.
Sits a ragged tent where there ain't no trees, and that gospel group telling you and me.
Mr. Eckerson does come out May 22nd. New film directed by me. And it has a huge cast, biggest cast of any KFTM movie. It takes place in the 1960s. It's a murder mystery. Go watch it when it comes out. It doesn't come out for quite a while, though. So just don't hold your breath for it. But it'll be out sooner rather than later. So go check out Mr. Eckerson on May 22nd. Now I have two more awards, and then we will get to another ad and then the finale. These awards are Best Animated Feature being presented by Christian Paestrup, and Best Original Song being presented by Jaren Talks Movies. Christian, take it away.
So, wait, is this thing on? It is? Okay. So, lots of animated movies came out this year. A lot of them. Some were really good. Others We're special. Anyways, we had a lot of great movies. We got I Lost My Body, which was this insane to the animated film. We had Klaus, which was this gorgeous, like, masterpiece in a lot of ways. Like this Christmas, Anyways, we had Lego Movie 2. We had How to Train Your Dragon 3, which, while not the best, was a pretty great finale. Frozen 2 was pretty decent, you know. It was overall a great, you know. We did have Adam's Family and Playmobil and Arctic Dogs and Secret Life of Pets 2. But other than that, it was a pretty great year for animation. Some stuff I still haven't seen that came out that year, over 2019. But there can only be one, and I have it right here. Who am I kidding? You already know what it is. It's Toy Story 4.
And thanks, Christian. Great video, because it's comical. I mean, we all knew Toy Story 4 was going to win. It won by a landslide, by the way, in the votes. Now we're going to go to Best Original Song by Jaren Talks Movies. And this is actually an award I wish I put more nominations for, but I only ended up putting 3. I could have put maybe 4 or 5, because there was a song from Parasite I didn't even know came out. So yeah, here's that award. Go to it, Jaren.
Hey there, guys. I'm so excited to be a part of this special award show celebrating all the greatest achievements in film from 2019. My name is Jaren. You can find me over at Jaren Talks Movies on YouTube. But I am here to present the winner for Best Original Song. The nominees are I Can't Let You Throw Yourself Away by Randy Newman, I'm Gonna Love Me Again from Taron Egerton and Elton John, and Into the Unknown from Idina Menzel. And the winner is I'm Gonna Love Me Again from Taron Egerton and Elton John. Congratulations to the winner. And if I'm being honest, that's the one I would pick too. That's a great song. Great picks, people. Good job.
Now we got one more ad for another KFTM Studios movie, and then it's the finale. Let's go to the ad. That is right, Derek hits the internet on July 31st. This is the new longest KFDM film at my approximate runtime at this point, an hour long. It's insane. It's an origin story for the villain of Transfer. Go check it out when it comes out on July 31st this summer. And I'm playing the main character, so it's like my big role. And now, get ready, because we got 2 more awards. Worst Picture being presented by my brother DJ Wolf, and then I will be giving y'all Best Picture. So this is Worst Picture presented by DJ Wolf, and boy is this a worst picture. Take it away, DJ. That wasn't supposed to rhyme.
My name is DJ P. Wolf. Here are the nominations for Worst Picture. I was much happier, but things changed after watching this. Playmobil, The Product. Ugly Dolls. Dark Phoenix. Replicas. Captive State. Countdown. And last and certainly least, Cats. Alright. Pulling out the envelope. And the pick for the worst, most awfulest, most terrible moving picture of 2019 is... yeah, it's Cats. Deserved. Please go subscribe to my channel for yearly uploads.
Yes, Cats deserve that. It deserved that so much. So, we're here now. This is my award. This is Best Picture. This is not my opinion on what the best movie of 2019 was. This is what won the polls. This was an incredibly slim poll. It was so freaking close. I was amazed by the polls, actually. It really surprised me which ones got up there and which ones were about to win, but this is Best Picture. The nominations are, you'll predict this one, I'll just let the posters be right here, Marriage Story, The Irishman, Avengers Endgame, I have to read this, I'll go, The Farewell, Joker, Knives Out, Parasite, Ford v Ferrari, and finally, Uncut Gems. And the award for Best Picture goes to Avengers Endgame. Look, I'm saying this already. You might think this was my choice, and you might think it's not fair that all the polls went down, but I'm being honest, this was a tie. This was tied for first. And I was not surprised Endgame got all these votes. But I had to, the other one I'm not even going to tell you because I don't want everybody to back on me for this decision. But I had to sit there and think, okay, which one is the movie that I think truly deserves Best Picture? And the other one's a fantastic, all these are fantastic, the other one's a phenomenal movie. And I'm just saying it's not Parasite. But I had to just think, okay, which one is the one that impacted the world? On this extent, $2.8 billion. And Martin Scorsese can say Marvel movies are just rides, but I don't usually cry of emotion and tears at the end of a ride. Avengers Endgame not only hit me on a level that no other movie ever has, it hit millions of people. Millions. It was, as a Marvel fan, it truly just gave me everything I've ever wanted to see in a Marvel movie. It's 3 hours long, but it never feels dull. I feel like this movie, in a lot of ways, deserves this type of huge award. I feel like it kind of deserves it, not just because it feels like Return of the King. I honestly really think the Oscars should have at least, frick, I think the Oscars should have given this movie a nomination for Best Picture. Let me hang this up again. I really think it deserved it because I think the movie is like, it's comparable to Return of the King, which won Best Picture. I think Return of the King's better, but still, this movie at least deserves some more than just best visual effects, because this movie has an incredible script, and even if there is all these issues with it, really, it's 3 hours long, and as a Marvel fan, I don't care. I do think Fortnite's dumb in the movie, but still, man oh man, a movie that impacted me more than I think any movie in 2019 did. I can say all I want, Marriage Story impacted me more, Parasite impacted me more, but no, Endgame really is the one that hit me the hardest because I am a Marvel fan, diehard Marvel fan, and I will always love Endgame, and I will rewatch this movie millions of times, even though it is 3 hours long. That's it. That's the awards. I was happy to present all this. This is a huge concept. Didn't even think it could go through, but it did. I'm happy about most of the wins. There are a couple I didn't really agree with, but that doesn't really matter. And I'm sorry I haven't made a lot of videos lately. This is the way I'm going to return. I'll be making like 2 more reviews soon, and then I'll be seeing movies weekly again. I just had a horrible, horrible January, okay? I had one of the worst months of my life, okay? I don't think it's really public why I should say it's a horrible month. But still, now I'm back. More movies are coming out. I saw Sonic, so I'll review that. I saw Little Women, I'll review that. And maybe I'll review Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, I don't know. But, yeah. This is a fun award show, and I'm happy of all the people that joined on. See you guys next time, and see all these other, go to all these other YouTube channels in the description, because they're all great. See you guys next time. Bye.